So I want to talk about artistry as a DJ. I've heard DJs referred to as musicians before. I'm still not sure how I feel about that, but I think we're definitely artists. Now you can see I got my hair cut. I'm getting ready to go to Mobile Beat Las Vegas 2019. Tomorrow's Monday. I leave for the show, and I'll be in town, I guess, sometime in the late afternoon. It's always fun to go to Mobile Beat. It's not afraid to be a mobile DJ conference. It's not trying to be clubby or anything else. And if you go to seminars and learn, that's great, but you can also learn from other DJs just in the hallways or sitting down and having a coffee with them or having a beer with them or whatever your thing is. You can learn about the business. You can learn about what they're doing in their market. You can learn about what the wedding trends are, and you can get inspired that way. A lot of hands-on with the equipment. You can check some stuff out, talk to some professionals about it. Now, you also have a lot of DJs who are performing at this conference, which is something I've never aspired to do. I don't want to perform for DJs like that, but a lot of people like to do it. There's a takeover usually, and they're just kind of playing self-indulgent sets at this takeover for other DJs. There's a stage, again, DJs playing self-indulgent sets for other DJs, and you'll have the same thing sometimes actually in the booths, the exhibit booths. You'll have DJs in there too. But you know what's missing from Mobile Beat is something that you can get in your hometown, and that is working with other peers who would be mobile DJs at their events. I had a friend over here just the other day. He brought his daughter over because I had some triples and quadruples of records that I was going to donate to charity. But he mentioned that his daughter was interested in crate digging. Why don't you just come over and grab it? You can go through it with her. And what you don't want, bring to the charity shop and bring me my cool crates back when you're done. So we were playing around for a while. We were checking out some of my mixes that I've done. I don't really play them for you guys, but I do. Play around with mixes and chops and samples and things like that. I used to do more of it on YouTube before the flagging started to happen. And he wanted her to see some of the stuff that I'd done. I showed her. We listened to it. And he's big into freestyle, Latin DJ. So his daughter knows it really well. And I played a freestyle mix. And he said, wow, I never would have thought to put those songs together like that. That's cool. And I thought to myself, you know, maybe if we'd work together once in a while, you'd have heard me do it, and it might have inspired you to give it a try, too. There's such a thing as what they call biting in the DJ business, where you hear another DJ's mix and you steal it. That's not really what I'm talking about here. What I'm talking about is just being inspired by another artist to kind of see what they're doing, to get some stimuli, I guess. I mean, when you're just doing this by yourself all the time, it can get kind of boring and stagnant. You have to see what other people are doing to have maybe a bar to reach, and just to get ideas. So I think it's very valuable. Even if you can't afford to go to a DJ conference or don't have time to go to one, if you're a mobile DJ, if you've got a friend in the area, work with them once in a while. Just go out and see what they're doing. You'll probably learn something about setup and about emceeing or about just how they manage their events. But you also might learn something about how to mix a couple tracks together or what song they're playing that's getting a really great reaction that you've never played before. And it's not the biting thing. It's not what I'm talking about. I'm just talking about getting inspired once again. You'll also see things that they do that you're thinking, that's okay, but I think I know how they can improve on it. So you help them too. You can offer those suggestions and show them things. So just a suggestion, work with other DJs when you can. You can get so much out of it. I do anyway. And I look forward to doing more of that this year. So that's it. Just a quick video for you. Hopefully I'll get some more stuff out tonight before I wrap everything to go to Vegas. But we'll do tons of videos in Vegas too. A lot of camera phone stuff like we did at NAMM. I think you'll like it. We'll see you then. Practice and enjoy.